What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English bit. It's been a while since our last pronunciation video. That's why for today's English bit, I've prepared the fifth edition with 10 more tricky words to pronounce. Are you ready to improve your pronunciation? So let's kick off. Let's start with a verb, which is firmar. The correct pronunciation is to sign. Be very careful, because a lot of my students would ask me if they had to sign the attendance sheet. And my answer was, no, you don't have to sign, you have to sign. No tienes que cantar, tienes que firmar. So be very careful. Firmar, to sign. Cantar, to sing. For example, would you sign here, please? Puedes firmar aquí? To sign, firmar. Remember. Now let's look at one adjective, which is sureño. The correct pronunciation is southern. Southern. So it's theta fuerte, v, southern. Be very careful, because if it's a noun, the pronunciation is south. South. So it's with u and theta at the end. South. So when it becomes an adjective, we don't pronounce southern, but southern. Southern. So there is no u and it's th. Southern. Southern. For example, I like the Spanish southern accent. Now let's start with our nouns. And the third word is super common and it's usually mispronounced. And it's lunes. So the correct pronunciation is Monday and not Monday. We don't pronounce O, it's A. Okay, this symbol, ma. Monday, Monday. For example, we are meeting next Monday. So remember, no Monday, Monday. Now let's move on to our noun number four, which is also commonly mispronounced. And it's the same as in Spanish, pub. But be very, very careful with the pronunciation. I don't know why, but a lot of Spanish people pronounce at the end the sound f and they say puff. The correct pronunciation is with the sound b. Pub. Pub. No puff. Pub. For example, let's go to a pub tonight. Pub. Now let's look at our noun number five, which is champagne. In English, the pronunciation is a bit different from the Spanish one. The first sound in English is not ch, like in Spanish, but sh, sh. So it would be sham, and at the end, the pronunciation is the same as pain, dolor. So it would be champagne, champagne. So it's not champagne, like in Spanish, but champagne, sh. Champagne. For example, I hardly ever drink champagne. And now let's move on to our noun number six, which is pasillo. The tricky thing here is that the letter S is silent. So we don't say aisle, but aisle. Aisle. So remember, we don't pronounce the letter S. Aisle. For example, I prefer an aisle seat. And you? Do you prefer a window seat or an aisle seat? Now let's move on to our word number seven, which is ley. Be very careful, because a lot of people pronounce this word like love, si fuera amor. And the correct pronunciation is long o, law, law. For example, my sister-in-law is my namesake. Namesake significa tocaya. She's also Katia. Our eighth word can be especially useful for your speaking exam to use in your topic, especially maybe at the beginning in your introduction. And the word is década. The correct pronunciation of this word is decade. Decade. So the stress goes on the first syllable. Decade. Decade. For example, there have been so many technological advances over the last decade. And as it's a pronunciation video, today we're going to learn how to pronounce correctly the word pronunciation, because it's usually mispronounced. A lot of people say pronunciation when the correct pronunciation of pronunciation is pronunciation. Pronunciation. We don't pronounce the sound U. Pronunciation. None. Pronunciation. Pronunciation. For example, you need to improve your pronunciation if you want to pass the exam. And to finish our English bit, we're going to look at three words which are usually mispronounced and confused. И son cerveza, oso y barba. Let's start with cerveza. The correct pronunciation is beer. Beer, the British beer or American beer. Beer. For example, I had a beer with my friend last night. Now let's look at the pronunciation of el oso. A lot of people would say beer when they want to say bear. So el oso in English is bear. Bear, not beer, but bear. Bear. For example, if I saw a bear, I would definitely freak out. And last but not least, the pronunciation of barba. The British pronunciation would be beard, beard, and in American, it would be with the sound R, beard, beard. For example, I don't like men with beards. So I really hope you found this English bit useful and it will help you correct some pronunciation mistakes. If you want to learn more, don't forget to check out the fourth edition right here. And of course, if you enjoyed this English bit, don't forget to like it and to subscribe to the channel. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao!